Greetings, brother. I am humbled by your question, and I pray that Almighty God can use me to answer you. I thought that once we were saved, we have the power to overcome sin through Christ, but I still have some issues with thoughts and my temper, etc., and have to ask for forgiveness daily. How do we stop sinning in that manner? I feel like it's very difficult. I will do my best to lay out an answer which I think you can use as food and as fuel in your fight against sin. But first, brother, to be thorough, I want to ask, have you been born again? Jesus taught what this phrase means when he was teaching Nicodemus. John 3:3, Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Verse 5, Jesus answered, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Realize that Jesus said this to a Jewish leader, a man faithful to Judaism. Nicodemus attended synagogue, memorized parts of the Torah, no doubt. He was so sincere that he risked his position to seek out Jesus, a man his heart told him to seek knowledge from. He had been a Jew his whole life, but still this faithful man was not born again, did not understand it. John 3:6, that which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said unto you, you must be born again. Being born of water means our natural birth. Being born of the Spirit means rebirth of our spirit. Simply stated, going to synagogue or church regularly does not mean you are born again. Being born again means that your spirit has been reborn with the life of God. When a person is born again, their spirit is literally reborn. Their spirit is reborn from God's incorruptible seed. 1 Peter 1:23, being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible, by the word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. You mention you are new to this, so I hope this is not drinking from a fire hydrant. Please ask any questions if something is not clear by the end of the video. The Bible reveals that a person is a Trinity, body, soul, and spirit. You may be born again in your spirit, but you still have the same body and soul. If your hair was dark, it will still be dark after you're born again. If you liked tacos, you'll still like tacos after you're born again. If you could catch a frisbee, you'll still be able to catch as well. Your body does not change, and that seems reasonable. But your soul also does not change, and that is where your battle is. So, brother, I must ask a question, and please, please do not be offended in any way. Have you ever been born again, brother? Have you made a decision and know that you asked Jesus to be your Lord, your Savior? If not, brother, you can accomplish much through self-discipline, but never be completely free from the nature of sin. If not, brother, please let me know, and that will be my next video. If you have, brother, and know consciously when you did, the rest of this video will make sense and I believe will help you. But I believe you are and have made a decision because your heart already has you asking to resist sin and please God. Moving on. If you are a new Christian, you should first begin to study the milk of the Word, just like a child needs milk. This is in no ways an insult. It is like laying the foundation of a building. 1 Peter 2:2, as newborn babes, that's born again, right? Desire the sincere milk of the Word, that you may grow thereby, if so be that you have tasted the Lord is gracious. Hebrews 6:1. Therefore, leaving the principles of the doctrine of Christ, let us go on unto perfection, not laying again the foundation of repentance from dead works and of faith toward God. So understanding the need to repent from sin and of having faith toward God, these are considered foundational things to becoming a Christian and then walking with God. Hebrews 6:2, of the doctrine of baptisms, and of laying on of hands, and of the resurrection of the dead, and of eternal judgment. And this will we do, if God permit. If these topics seem foreign, or funny, or anachronistic, meaning out of time, you may need some foundation work, brother. It saddens me that many churches do not teach such foundational topics clearly and consistently to new Christians. So there are certain things which the Bible categorizes as milk, and some topics as meat. And the thing you need is the milk of the Word of God, brother, taken daily in consistent doses. Hebrews 4:12, for the Word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Notice that the Word of God helps discriminate between the soul and the spirit. It can discern or judge between your thoughts and your intents. Your intentions. Your intentions come from your spirit, brother, and your intention is to stop sinning. Your thoughts are in your mind, which is part of your soul. Remember, when you were born again, your soul does not instantly change, and that is where your battle is. Your battle is in your soul, in your mind, your will, and your emotions. So the short answer is that you win this battle against temptation by changing your thinking. And the Word of God speaks very directly to this topic. Praise the Lord. Romans 12:2. And be not conformed to this world, but be you transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Remember, we just read that the thoughts are in our mind, which is not born again. But this verse encourages us to be transformed by the renewing of our minds. Transformed means changed. We renew our minds by filling our minds with the Word of God. Yes, that does mean some memorization. Psalm 119:11, Thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee. That is your goal. But do not set yourself up for disappointment. The man who wrote this, David, he still sinned. So none of us are perfect, but that is the finish line we walk towards as we follow the Lord. The Word of God is part of the cleansing process, brother. Ephesians 5:25. Husbands, love your wives even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it by the washing of water by the Word. The Word of God is like water that may wash and cleanse us. Now our sins can only be washed away by Jesus' blood. But once we are born again, Jesus still washes us with his Word. So part of the cleansing is constant exposure to the Word of God, brother. Proverbs 23:6. For as he thinketh in his heart, so is he. As a man thinks in his heart, so is he. I think you well know what thoughts you have, brother. And the goal is to change your thought life. Part of that change is to learn about forgiveness. And perhaps this will help with your temper. Proverbs 15:1, a soft answer turns away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger. Meditate on this, brother, and allow yourself to give a kind or a soft answer when you're offended. Proverbs 16:32, he that is slow to anger is better than the mighty, and he that rules his spirit than he that taketh a city. Think about what this says, brother. Your manliness is not based on your anger. A better man can control himself, his anger, and his tongue. As you meditate the Word of God, it brings life, brother. It transforms you. And I think there are even more verses I should offer. Psalm 119:105, thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. 2 Timothy 2:15, study to show yourself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Psalms 1:1, blessed is the man that walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law does he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that brings forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he does shall prosper. Notice that verse 1 says to stop listening to ungodly counsel. That is half of the equation, brother. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law does he meditate day and night. Then meditate on the scriptures that apply to whatever your situation is, my friend. If it's lust, if it's anger, if it's unforgiveness, whatever it is, find the scriptures that apply and then meditate on them. Given time, brother, even your senses can be developed to know good and evil. Hebrews 5:14, but strong meat, remember we talked about the milk and the meat of the word? Strong meat belongeth to them that are of full age, even those who by reason of use have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil. Remember I mentioned the milk and the meat of the word. This verse encourages persistence. Stay the course and hold on. Eventually, even your senses will be transformed to know good and evil. If anger is an issue, my friend, think about the forgiveness you have received. Once you realize how God forgave you, it may become easier to forgive others. After all, brother, on the cross, Jesus forgave the very men who crucified him. And any offense I have experienced in life falls way below that. It helps me forgive. Anger, road rage, forgive. Sometimes we doubt God. This is how Satan attacks us to trick us. But just as Jesus could quote the Word of God, you too need to learn what it says. Mark 9:23, Jesus said unto him, if you can believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. This is the story about the man whose daughter is dead. And straightway the father of the child cried out and said with tears, Lord, I believe, but help thou my unbelief. God, please help me. Don't ever be afraid to admit your need. And always remember that Satan is the accuser of the brethren. Revelation 12:10, and I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now is come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ. For the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accused them before God day and night. Satan's strategy is to tempt you, then trip you, then guilt you. 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. 1 John 2:1, My little children, these things write I unto you, that you sin not. And if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. See, Jesus still intercedes for us, because he knows we will be tempted, and we will sin. But we're walking away from that. Part of your responsibility, brother, is to choose to not give your body as a slave to the sin, like I said in the previous video. Choose to avoid the situation where the sin presents itself as easy temptation. But the strength to resist, the will to make the right choice, comes from transforming your mind by meditating on the Word of God. Philippians 4:8, Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things. And the Holy Spirit inside you will teach you all things. And the Holy Spirit will bring all things, all the scriptures, all the meditation, to your memory during the time of temptation. Philippians 3:13. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. I think that sums up my heart, brother. I am not perfect, but I desire to hear God say, "Well done, good and faithful servant." And one final scripture to embolden you, brother. We have reviewed the scriptures which speak of what to do with your mind. Well, allow me to present a whiff of the steak. Philippians 2:5. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself, and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. 1 John 4:15. Whosoever shall confess that Jesus is the Son of God, God dwelleth in him, and he in God. You've confessed Jesus is the Son of God, so God dwells in you, and you are dwelling in God. You may not realize that you can't perceive him, but you are in God. And we have known and believed the love that God has to us. God is love, and he that dwells in love dwells in God, and God in him. Herein is our love made perfect, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. That's talking about right now. Because as he is, think about how Jesus is right now. As he is, so are we in this world. That's not milk, that's meat. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, because fear has torment. He that still fears is not yet made perfect in love. Dear Jesus, may your word of life bring life to your child. May he sense even now a hunger for your word, Lord. Give him an insatiable desire for your word, Lord. Bless his memory. Help him remember your word. Pour out your Holy Spirit on the open heart, Lord. in Jesus' precious name. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.